afraid of anything.
One night she thought she'd take a walk.
She walked so long and so far that it started to get dark. There was only a sliver of moon shining through the night. The little old lady started to walk home. Suddenly, she stopped. Right in the middle of the path, there were two big shoes, and the shoes went, "Get out of my way, you two big shoes. I'm not afraid of you," said the little old lady. On she walked down the path, but behind her, she could hear two shoes go. A little farther on, the little old lady stumbled into a pair of pants, and the pants went, "Get out of my way, you pair of pants. I'm not afraid of you." Said the little old lady, and she walked on. But behind her, she could hear two shoes go, and one pair of pants go. Farther still, the little old lady bumped into a shirt, and the shirt went, "Get out of my way, you shirt. I'm not afraid of you," said the little old lady. And she walked on, but a little bit faster. But behind her, she could hear two shoes go, one pair of pants go, and one shirt go. A little ways on, the little old lady came upon two white gloves and a tall black hat. And the gloves went, and the hat went, "Get out of my way, you two white gloves and you tall black hat. I'm not afraid of you," she said. And she walked on just a little bit faster, but behind her she could hear two shoes go, one pair of pants go, and one shirt go, two gloves go, and one hat go. But now the little old lady was walking at quite a fast pace. She was very near her cottage when she was startled by a very huge, very orange, very scary pumpkin head. And the head went... This time the little old lady did not stop to talk. She did not stop at all. She ran, but behind her she could hear two shoes go, one pair of pants go, one shirt go, two gloves go, one hat go, and one scary pumpkin head go. The little old lady did not look back. She ran as fast as she could and didn't stop to catch her breath until she was safe inside her cottage with the door locked. She sat in her chair by the fire and she rocked and she rocked. It was so quiet in her cottage before the on the door. Should she answer it? Well, she was not afraid of anything, so she went to the door and she opened it. What do you think she saw? Two shoes go, one pair of pants go, one shirt go, two gloves go, and one hat go. And one very scary pumpkin head go. "I'm not afraid of you," said the little old lady bravely. "What do you want, anyway? We've come to scare you." "You can't scare me," said the little old lady. "Then what's to become of us?" The pumpkin head suddenly looked very unhappy. "I have an idea," said the little old lady. Then she whispered into the pumpkin's ear. The pumpkin head nodded and its face seemed to brighten. The little old lady said goodnight, closed the door, and whistled on her way to bed. The next morning she woke up early. She went to her window and looked into her garden, and what do you think she saw? Two shoes go, one pair of pants go, one shirt go, two gloves go, one hat go,